And the shoe falls him as he tries to further his goals to become god of the human world. As far as the other important characters go, there's Misa, Light's girlfriend, and Elle, and Nier, who are basically Light's rivals through parts of the story. Now, near the end of the series, Nier and Light have one final showdown to see who's better able to counteract the other's plan. They go to an abandoned warehouse for the final showdown, and in the end, Nier is proven the victor. Now, he explains that he simply saw through Light's plan to use a fake notebook, which was given to Teru Mikan. He's basically Kira when Light's not Kira. However, what if Nier didn't, in fact, outsmart him like that? What if, in fact, there was much more being manipulated from behind the scenes? Basically, what I'm thinking is that Nier used the Death Note to completely destroy Light's chances of winning. This is a theory that's already been discussed by some others, but I wanted to add my own spin to it. There is some interesting evidence to support it that I found, so let's dig right in. Now, during the time just before Light replaced the notebook with a fake one, Nier was having one of the detectives investigate Mikami, the replacement for Kira. Mikami, as shown in the show, builds up almost ritualistic habits and follows them perfectly. During the periods of time where Mikami was at the gym, Nier and the detectives were able to discover that yes, Mikami had the Death Note. Now, let's think about this. Nier had a lot of time before the notebook was replaced, and they were checking up on this notebook extremely often. It's not completely out of the realm of possibility that they could have used the Death Note during any of these gym visits. So what if Nier did use the notebook, you ask? Well, my fine feathered friend, it changes a lot, actually. Let's think about what transpired before Light was caught. Mikami was writing the names of everyone but Light in the notebook. It turned out to be completely fake and didn't have any pieces of paper from the original Death Note, which I remind you that Nier had at the end of the series as well. After this doesn't work, and both Light and Mikami have gotten caught, Mikami literally kills himself. Now, you could say this is due to his supposed god finally getting caught, but why would he do this at this moment and in this way? It seems very odd and out of place, even if it's supposed to be a distraction, almost like he was commanded to do so by the Death Note. The timing just seems a little too perfect. The way in which Mikami was murdered and the ability to use the Death Note at any time aren't the only things that support this theory, however. Let's look at Nier's character for a moment, shall we? From his literal reveal, we are told that Nier lacks any serious emotion. This is shown throughout the series, as Nier never displays even the slightest bit of emotion, whether it be fear, sadness, happiness, etc. He is presented as being merely just emotionless. What, then, is stopping him from using the Death Note? If he doesn't feel regret, it wouldn't matter to him if he accidentally killed the wrong person or accused the wrong person of being Kira. He would have simply just apologized later, and that'd be that. There's no doubt that he'd be fully capable of doing this. And think about it, this was the perfect plan. By using the Death Note, there's no way Nier could have lost.
Yes.
The moment he wrote in the Death Note, he could control Mikami's every move, and he could control him for a very large sum of time. All he had to do was use the Death Note to control Mikami, to use the wrong notebook, and boom, Light loses. There's almost no way Light could predict such an event, as shown in the anime, he couldn't even predict Nier's supposed normal plan. Even if he had managed to predict it, there's very little he could do about it. Light would look really suspicious if he didn't go to the meeting, and both the notebooks were completely out of his control at this point. In a literal sense, if Nier did do this, there is almost no way Light could have beaten Nier. There's simply no way of him predicting such a plan and almost no way of avoiding it. In this case, Nier can't lose. There's just no way. So, why wouldn't he do it? And for those of you that will ask, yes, there is a reason why he wouldn't admit to it in the anime. Admitting to this would essentially be saying that Nier cheated to beat Light. And this would also make him look pretty bad. I know he doesn't have emotions, but he still seems to have some kind of pride. Also, he could have possibly needed the notebook later to kill Misa, as we don't really know why she died. This way, he seems like he outsmarted Light, and has a guaranteed win to boot. So, in the end, Light's efforts to try and beat Nier were completely meaningless. Nier used the notebook to beat him flat out, and there was virtually no way to stop it. Considering the amount of time he had access to it, Mikami's strange death, Nier's complete lack of remorse, and the potential gain he gets from using it, there's almost no reason why he wouldn't use it. I guess in the end, Light's brains weren't even near his opponents. I apologize for that one, but in the end, this is just my crazy theory. Whether you believe my points well, and I hope you enjoyed the video overall. If you have an anime or theory you want me to cover, just tell me in the comments.
Wait, is that a baby on the field? Defensive linemen are playing peekaboo.
Harris now appears to be burping the baby.
We don't need any more trick plays.
Harris is off to the races!
But we could all use more ways to save.
Touchdown!
I have a challenge for all of you. Go to every computer in your house, your mom's, your dad's, your sister, your brother's computer.
If you have not watched Death Note, please be aware that this video will contain spoilers regarding the anime. You have been warned. So firstly, let's rewind how Death Note ended. I mean, do you know a single person or Death Note fan who hasn't at least questioned or pondered upon the unfolding narrative in that final scene? Nier's proof and logic and deducing Light as being Kira from the whole confrontation to conclusion in that single moment summarizes the epitome of his investigation and season 2, his breakdown in evidence that leads directly to Light's downfall. One thing that I realized when finishing Death Note for the first time is that the natural inclination for a viewer is to think that Death Note has Light's story. However, it's not. It's Ryuk's. If you're still not convinced, think about the fundamental scene in which the theory of Light becoming a Shinigami features. It shows Ryuk with a Shinigami about to explain the story of Light and the experience with the Death Note. An amazing jaw-dropping story at that for us! Ryuk says himself, the world was interesting, the story about a man trying to change the world and become a god to people, an experience he would never forget for the rest of his life. Seems quite fitting to us Death Note fans as well, huh? The epic build-up upon Kira's death and Light fading away as he lays on the stairwell, which some may say is symbolic, as you have to remember the news of a Death Note can either go to heaven or hell, the top of the stairwell signifying heaven and the bottom hell. Light is smack in the middle, implying this very notion. It kind of felt as though we went with the guy. The journey came to a close. You have to keep in mind that Kira was around for 7 years in the Death Note universe. He literally changed the world. Crime rates went significantly down and hardcore criminals were not to be found. He actually helped the world in some ways. A cult of Kira worshippers, which you cannot forget too, even after Kira's death, they still worship him. In the epilogue of Death Note, it is revealed that upon Kira's death, crime rate was rising to pre-Kira levels again. The world without him was simply returning to his previous state of misery. So why do people believe Light became a Shinigami? Even I thought so when I finished Death Note for the first time. There is compelling evidence to make you believe so. So the unnamed Shinigami, who is the core of this theory, is featured in Death Note Relight 1, Visions of God, and he sets up the plot for telling the story of Light Yagami and the Death Note. Just like Ryuk, he says he is bored of the Shinigami realm and ponders off to try and see if he can go to the human realm. So as I said before in the anime, it is revealed that all news of the Death Note go to nothingness, and most people may assume that this means purgatory. But fans may argue that this can mean the Shinigami realm, because if you take a look at the realm itself, it's really dull and nothing. Why does Ryuk and the unnamed Shinigami say it's really boring otherwise? Ryuk wanted to go to the human realm because he was bored. The unnamed Shinigami shares this same attitude like Ryuk before he went to the human realm. The unnamed Shinigami is intrigued with the human realm and will find it more interesting. He doesn't even stay to hear the end of Ryuk's story, and it's kinda implied that he may have an agenda to why he wants to go. This kinda makes people think this Shinigami is Light, and which then also means the speculation that the Shinigami can possibly be previous users of Death Note, as they can neither go to heaven or hell. You can assume the purpose of the Shinigami world is to force the individuals who took the opportunity to kill out of hatred or selfish intent to see what it may be like to do nothing but watch human beings love one another and to lose those people out of their lives for eternity. Thus, they can atone and realize love influences your actions more than self-centeredness, and you can then end your life to save a human being, just like Shinigami Jealous did for a woman he loved as he overlooks her. So who is this unnamed Shinigami? A lot of people are not even aware of this scene. Essentially, the unnamed Shinigami only appears in the anime relight films, which take place in their own continuity. The relight films rewrite some scenes of the original anime series, some dialogue changes here and there, and adding some animated scenes, and of course the introduction of the unnamed Shinigami. There is quite a few similarities between the Shinigami and Light. So what are the points and factors that argue this theory? It is possible that a Shinigami's appearance represents who they were as a human or how they died. Some people can interpret it like that. So, clothing and appearance. Number 1. The red tie which is around Shinigami's head is the exact same one which Light sported all of the time in the human realm for his school uniform. Number 2. The Shinigami has goggles on his head, which seems unusual to the gothic design that all other Shinigami have. It may insinuate the fact that Light did not take the deal to have Shinigami eyes, unlike others. Number 3. This particular Shinigami carries a messenger bag for some reason, and it's identical to the one Light often carried during his time at high school. Number 4. This Shinigami has spiked hair, and it seems to be the same length, color, and texture as Light. Number 5. So we all remember Light's dramatic scenes in his inner monologue, right? Who can you forget the scene where he takes a potato chip and eats it?
Just watch me, Al. I'll solve equations with my right hand and write names with my left. I'll take a potato chip and eat it.
One key thing to notice and is awesome is that Light gets bright red eyes due to the symbolic moments and artistry, right? Shinigami have red eyes too, including the unnamed Shinigami, which may be a link to Light as he's kinda like a Shinigami. Number 6. Death Note Opening 2 has a lot of symbolism towards the last 10 seconds in which it showcases Light, Crows, the Shinigami realm, and Ryu. And a quick glimpse of Light with a Shinigami appearance as if he is going through a metamorphosis into a Shinigami. Watch the sequence here. Light can be seen standing in the Shinigami realm too. This can be a foreshadowing to the events to come and his reincarnation as a Shinigami after death. Number 7. The way the unnamed Shinigami walks is the same as Light Yagami upon his death, as he had a limp due to his wounds. The Shinigami walking towards Ryuk also has some sort of limp or a mannerism similar to Light.
Squarespace is a one-stop shop that helped me set up my online store easily.
That's not everything, by the way. This theory is backed up by more. Let's talk about the Shinigami handing the apple to Ryuk. How did this unnamed Shinigami know of Ryuk and ask other Shinigami of his whereabouts? Is it because he held some memory of his past life? Is that why he doesn't wait to hear the end of Ryuk's story about Light Yagami? Because he already knows how it ends?
Itala. Itemiruaiza.
Shinigami seems to be a new one too. No one seems to recognize him or know of him at all. In addition, Ryuk says it himself. Who are you? This means it must be a new Shinigami, further indicating it's a reincarnation of Light. Furthermore, evidence to this theory is that Light in the human realm with Ryuk knew that he loves Apple. How does this unnamed Shinigami have knowledge of this? The way he seems to toss the apple with confidence and affirmation also seems to be in the same manner as Light or a human. Shinigami possess senses of taste similar to those of humans. They do not eat food, however. In the human world, Misa Shinigami Rem specifically states that all Shinigami ingestive system is either rotten or evolved, and that they don't need substances to sustain themselves. Since Light is the one of the only people we know in the Death Note universe to know that Ryuk loves apples, This must mean this Shun Shinigami could be Light, as he may have some memories about Ryuk from his past life. Ryuk's interaction with the unnamed Shinigami in Belfry Light films 1 and 2, in which he appears in, is really vague. It can be interpreted by viewers as Ryuk referring to Shinigami as Light, because after looking at his own Death Note, Ryuk speaks to Light as if he were there, with his quote saying, "You were not a god, you were just, oh, gone already?" This could possibly imply Ryuk was addressing the Shinigami as Light, or that he was reminiscing the past. The directing also in this scene also implies it shows a shot of Ryuk's Death Note right after showing the Shinigami with the name Light Yagami. Why would you direct something in such a manner without trying to suggest something to the viewers?
あの時のお前は神なんかじゃなかった。あれはむしろ